What is going on YouTube? Hannah back making another brand new crypto TV episode. In today's video, we're going to be looking at Litecoin, Bitcoin, Ethereum, as well as ICX, also known as Icon 2BTC. We'll be doing a current coin market analysis as well as doing market analysis, you know, discussing where exactly Litecoin's price is headed in the near future, as well as looking at the other altcoins to see where exactly they tie into cryptocurrency. And are we going to see some bigger moves as we head up to, as we know, the Litecoin halving? It's going to be very interesting. If you guys are new to the channel, make sure to subscribe, turn on post notifications, leave a giant thumbs up, and let's jump right into today's video. So as you guys can see, before we start, you can see that we're on the current coin market cap. Market cap is $336.3 billion, 24-hour volume is $69.3 billion, and Bitcoin dominance is $62.8 billion. So the markets are moving up, volume is slowly moving into, you know, the cryptocurrencies. We're starting to see some swings to the upside, very minor. Don't get that wrong. Very, very, very minor swings. But you'll notice we are starting to see some green all across the board. I literally think majority of the market today is up, you know, and doing very well. We do see some currencies that are up double digits, like crypto.com chain. I didn't even know you could make a coin like that, but I guess you can call it anything. And we are starting to see coins move to the upside. Icoin, ICX, the one that we're going to review today, is up. Icon is up 14.5%. So we'll look at that, discuss why that is. This was recommended by one of our Patreon subscribers, so that was absolutely awesome. We're going to be checking this out. You can see it in the top 10 cryptocurrencies. We do have Litecoin still holding strong, the number 4 position. Interesting thing is now Bitcoin Cash is very close, only $100 million off, which I know sounds like a lot, but that can move in a blink of an eye in the crypto sphere. So you can also see Bitcoin is at 4.5% in, you know, positive change volume, and you can see the price is at 11,875. So we are still capping off at 12,000. We got to check that out in a second. Ethereum, nice to see that back above $300. We see XRP at 0.4. We haven't really looked at XRP in a while, so maybe we'll review that soon. And Litecoin is 120. So I do just want to move on over to our, you know, cryptocurrencies, move on over to the Litecoin charting, kind of see what exactly is going on. So I was unfortunately not able to make a video yesterday. You know, it is the July 4th holiday season, got really busy, didn't have time to make a video, but I'm here now to make a video and to cover up what exactly we missed yesterday and today. So what's interesting is ever since the last video that I made, we were in a downtrend, we were retracing, we were pulling back down. We have not seen any green since my last video, but now we come on with a surprise that we're starting to see correction and we're starting to see movement. And I did say in the previous video that we were going to see some sort of potential retest off this bottom support and move up. Now I said that this ascending wedge that's slowly carrying us up into some sort of ascending triangle formation is holding very well, and that's clearly indicating that we're going to see a nice bounce off here, and that's really what we're looking at right now. So we did test, you know, we did cap off at 143. For those of you who are new to the channel, you wouldn't know that we were talking about this, but just to quickly recap, we hit a resistance of 140 in our major ascending triangle that all you guys should know by now. You can see right here we do have this purple ascending wedge, which slowly formed into an ascending triangle as we headed higher up. And you can see it's starting to act as a pretty strong resistance up at the top here. You'll notice that this is right at our top of the overbought line on the RSI. And you can see we're still pumping higher. We're still trading out. We're still moving to higher levels. From that previous fall, we fell all the way down to like 109, and we're currently at 120. So Litecoin is still going to pump higher. We're still moving up. It looks great all in all. I think, you know, yesterday and two days ago was a great buying opportunity to, you know, snag some more cryptocurrency, some Litecoin in specific, because of the fact that we are so close to testing this bottom support. Honestly, any of these tests we know on the bottom support line is a great buying opportunity because we usually bounce up higher. And you can see that every, you know, bottom on here, we've then headed up to higher levels, which is a great, you know, thing to see. And it does pretty much, you know, solidify the fact that this uptrend is here to stay, and it does have some significant importance. So pretty much just to sum up what my plans are for Litecoin is, obviously the halving comes up, I believe it's the beginning to mid of August, and we should see, I forgot when the specific date, and I'll get that for you guys, but we should anticipate from here, we had our downtrend, We went from an overbought market now to a neutral, trading at 50 on the RSI, or a little bit lower, 46. We should then anticipate to see some sort of movement to the upside like this. We're looking for a correction. We're looking for retracement up. We're looking for that, you know, that flip in the market. We should start to see some volume heading in soon. Now, another reason why I have my beliefs on that is because you can see we've had practically no volume. Volume has practically died off the past couple of days. You also notice trading flatlined on the 50, on the RSI. We didn't just like touch it and then spike up. We've been just trading, you know, flatlined out on there for quite some time. So in the short term, I am anticipating some sort of movement like this to the upside. Obviously, then we'll have more resistance at 140, but you know, that's a $20 gain on every coin in terms of Litecoin that you purchase, because obviously it's 120 right now. And I do plan on seeing some sort of move, some sort of retestment above 140, 142, 143, up to that level. So this is really what I'm focusing on right now to make some great money off that play. Now, moving on to Bitcoin. Bitcoin is interesting. You know, obviously I've had to restart my computer. My external hard drive has been giving me crazy issues, but I did have to reset my computer and it changed up my cryptocurrency charts just a tad. So you got to bear with me, but I know we've been talking about this ascending, you know, triangle formation, this uptrend right here on Bitcoin's graph. And you'll know that we've been hitting caps up top at around $12,000. We've had numerous retestments of this where we've broken bearish from. You can see we do have a bottom uptrend though, which is, you know, holding in semi nicely. Very hard to graph this. That's why I'm not too sure that it is here to stay and how strong it is, because obviously there was a movement up here and there is a movement down here. So these confirm that we do have support. This confirms we have resistance. But all of this right here where it wasn't on the uptrend is kind of a little finicky. I can kind of move it like this. This might be a little bit better where we traded on the top, or sorry, on the bottom, then the top, and then back to the top. So this more so looks familiar with me. This looks more, you know, of a confirmation. But you can see we're starting to hit a resistance at $12,000. We're testing this right now. We're nearing overbought. We're only trading at 62, so there is room to move up higher, but there is resistance here. But it looks like overall the market is supposed to be heading up. It looks like as we, you know, approach the end or the beginning of August, we should see the currencies move up to higher levels, potentially testing new all-time highs for 2019. Not, you know, all-time highs, but newer highs for 2019, ones that it has not hit yet within the year. And I'm anticipating that to happen based on the way this market's been trading ever since the beginning of, you know, I want to say December, you know, the end of December, beginning of January for 2019. We've all seen movements to the upside. We've been in a bull market since January. We've retested, we've broken previous highs, and we're doing absolutely crazy. We're doing phenomenal. So we should expect to see some more, you know, levels up to the upside. Litecoin halving does somewhat affect, but I think it's short term. Buy the rumor, sell the news. I think it's a very short term play on Litecoin's price. As for Bitcoin, Ethereum, and the rest of the cryptos, they're going to still pump higher, and I think it's going to bring Litecoin up with it. So I'm really anticipating some gradual movements to the upside. And I think there's not as much volume and media and hype wrapped around the cryptocurrencies indicating that we should see a more stagnant, slow growth to the upside instead of just a major spike, you know, straight up, which then has a parabolic correction downside and a lot of people get pissed. So I don't think it's a bubble. I think that was pretty crazy when the media called it that. Ethereum looks even more confirmed than Bitcoin. So that's why I like to use other cryptocurrencies besides just one to, you know, to track and record and to chart, mainly because this has a much better, you know, outlook, and this has a beautiful uptrend right here. You can see where it clearly hits as a resistance and then support. Bitcoins, you can see similar, but not as, you know, as perfect as Ethereum's is. So you can see this is clearly taking us higher up to higher levels, and it looks like we're about to break a cap. We have a resistance of around 308. If not a little bit higher. This is a resistance area, and it looks like we're trying to break through that in the next couple of days. We could see even today a pop in Ethereum's to the upside. 370 is a cap right here, as well as, let me move this down here, not sure why it's black. We do have a cap right here as well at around 336. Let me make this a little thinner. So that is a problem zone that we could expect, but I do think we're going to slowly climb up. If we continue to follow this uptrend like we've been doing, we should be seeing major moves to the upside. So I do think To start this week, we're looking very well. I think we're headed higher, and I think we will see some previous highs being retested this week. I think it's going to be pretty big. You know, we've had our consolidation the past couple of days, and now we're starting to see some correction and movement to the upside. So all in all, it looks really good. Now, lastly, to wrap up today's episode, we're going to look at Icon ICX. This was recommended to me by a subscriber on Patreon. You know, if you guys wanted to check out my Patreon, it's the first link in the description, and you can see that we do have a downtrend forming. Icon is quite an interesting token. I'm not sure how much of a fan I am of it. Now, I don't really know too much about its, you know, its reasoning for being a cryptocurrency, their company, but you can see what exactly has been going on ICX. You can see how high it was previously, and then we've had major retracements, and we've pretty much been setting all-time lows ever since, you know, we corrected back in, I want to say, December or January of 2018. So now to move in a little bit closer, I guess there is 100% so money to be made in a currency like this. You'll notice on the weekly, we are literally running on the oversold market, on the oversold line. As I move us over to the daily before we wrap things up, you'll notice there is a big descending triangle forming. We're pretty much just hanging out below our high, low, middle moving averages. And you can see where we've just been continuously pulling back down lower. This is for sure a beautiful downtrend that will need to be broken before we see any sort of movement to the upside. Now, the one thing which kind of I'm on the fence about with ICX is the fact that ICX does not have any previous lows to base this off of. You know, if we just decide to go any lower below this purple support right here, it's a new low. There's no history that shows where it could be bouncing off resistance. There's nothing. So it would be all new to us, and we don't want to trade on a new market. It's very hard. It's pretty much the easiest way to gamble. It's like Russian roulette. You're just betting on black or white, 50-50 chance we correct. But with this downtrend right here, we can consider that we're going to see some sort of impaction or movement off of right here. Anywhere up here where we retest this, we could see either a pullback like we've seen previously, where it goes like this, and falls lower, or we're finally going to see that consolidation and then a pop back to the high low of May. That's pretty much where I see ICX going, but that's going to sum up the episode for today, guys. If you're new to the channel, make sure to subscribe, turn on those notifications, leave a giant thumbs up, and I'll see you guys in tomorrow's video. Peace.